Oh, you want to be the cameraman?
No, go ahead, start cutting.
Okay.
You're gonna snap the blade if you go too fast.
Okay, you feel it's loose on there.
Do it gradually.
Done.
That was quick.
So I was just in front of this.
Yeah, we can trim that out. Like I said,
you can always file the edges if you want, but I mean, like,
it doesn't have to be.
No one's ever going to see it.
Underneath,
exactly.
Right, so if you're like a quarter inch a little bigger, or, you know, it's not a big deal. But, you know, cut. The bob is in the end, we trimmed it.
You gotta drill out the hole later for the drain plug instead?
Yeah.
You gotta just trace that out.
This piece off now.
There you go.
Okay, so now we got this piece here.
Maybe we'll put it this way.
Making skid plates.
Okay, we'll slowly bring it down. Okay.
Oh, there you go.
Just got
the box. That's okay. That's it. That's pretty much the shape.
Base now. Oh, I gotta make a couple more cuts maybe. For the bends.
Okay.
So that's the base. And then we start making our bends on here. See, that's perfect. And then we have to like shape like a...
Well, how do we call that?
Put a little groove in there. Okay, so put it back down again. Okay, so now, see, these are gonna bend up. So I gotta go straight, or go like that a little bit. And then these we're gonna bend upwards.
You gotta heat it up or something, or?
Yeah, well, first I gotta make the cut. And then
and then mold it in. That's the only two that you gotta do?
Yeah, just two cuts there. And then I gotta shave in here like
that corner there. Maybe you want to round off.
Yeah, I'll round it off.
If it goes beyond the end, just a wee bit.
So this folds like that. See? Fold in there. So these cuts. See how I gotta make these cuts?
Yeah.
Okay. So let's see.
That's your design, though.
Yeah.
Right? To make the cuts unangled?
Yeah. There you go. So there's the line. See the line?
Cut them on an angle, yeah.
So it's pretty much a straight cut there. Yeah, oh, just a straight cut.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's beautiful.
Just want to make sure.
This is already cracked.
Yeah, that's your old one.
Yeah, those are the stock ones. They're like...
Yeah.
Fuck, if I only knew when I was doing mine. I did all mine in...
Can you stop swearing on camera?
Parts for aluminum.
Oh, okay.
Cost it an arm and a leg.
$900.
Yeah, each piece. I guess there's like about seven or eight pieces underneath. The sides are separate than the middle. This is all one, right?
Yeah.
The nice thing about the one is if I have to get to a part, I just take out one skid plate instead of the whole thing. But you're also cacking out $1,000. Oh, there's no swearing allowed on YouTube?
Yeah, and my wife watches the video and then she's gonna say, "Oh, what's the matter with that guy always swearing?"
Okay, well, tell your wife not to watch the video.
It swears more than you.
Yeah, no kidding.
Yeah, just go straight to there, okay? And then stop there.
Don't cut the rim. We need that.
Just a straight cut. Round edge on it. Up here in this corner.
Looks like you've done this before.
And like I said, you know, plus or minus, and then once you form it up and you put it on your machine, then you say, okay, you don't need to trim this up and make a few more adjustments. End of the day, it's under your machine. Nobody's going to see it.
Yeah. Well, it ends when everything is...
Yeah, but you want to heat it up now?
Huh?
You know how much to mold it to? Yeah. To bend it? Or don't you want it to be on the machine and then...
Well, we bend it and then we put it on the machine and that's because everything's going to sit snug to that. Right? Now, once we get that snug, then I know how much more to trim to here to fit it snug, right? You know what I mean?
Yeah. And you're going to bend it by hand or you're going to put like a little thing there, and like a straight edge, like a straight edge?
I wish I had a straight edge. Pretty much all by hand. I'm going to put gloves on, is it going to get hot? And just bend it. Once you heat it up, it stays. And then you got to hold it like that for...
Yeah, until it cools off.
And I say, hey, this is what we have, you know? Got to deal with what we got. It's probably the hardest part of the whole thing, is just...
Wait, sitting and waiting.
Once you get it, it goes pretty good after.
There's like surgery over here now, you know? Gotta wait.
Once it gets loose, and then it's gonna be patient. Put this flat, put that down, and start bending up, right? I'll keep the heat on it. No, not those yellow gloves. There's the thicker ones.
Oh, there?
Yeah. There's a yellow, thicker one.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they'll probably be better for the heat. You can see how the heat's penetrating now? That gets shiny.
Easy.
Keep the pressure on, and then you'll just start feeling the bend.
How much of a bend do you have to do?
All the way up.
Oh, straight up?
Yep.
How'd you do it? One person?
I used my ratchet straps. I put a ratchet strap across.
Sometimes you got a MacGyver something, eh?
Yeah, when you're by yourself, yeah. So I got Gary's hands here, so you on the camera.
Nice cold drink would be good. Where's the bartender?
The wife.
Good thing Nick's not here. Oh, you're going to get a comment on that one there for sure.
Yeah, he's going to make the comment.
Oh,
I know.
For
he's
sure, 100%.
Yeah. I just can just imagine what he's going to say.
I don't even want to know.
Actually, that's pretty good. Then.
That's good. That's
can
good.
I just hold it in place now, Gary? We're going for a coffee. We'll see how far.
Yeah, try not to move back too much, Gary.
Here, bend it more down because it's going to bend back. That's it.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, see how it bends back?
Yeah.
Keep like that for a bit, and then it'll bend back. Then to bend it back, it's easy. Just put a little heat, then it'll just start.
It springs back.
By a certain point.
When you heat it up, you can mold it to anything you want.
That's why if we were going to do the other stuff, the HMUV, whatever it's called there, it'd probably be a lot harder to bend. I don't know, I never worked with it. But.
Now you got me all excited about that carbon fiber.
I don't know, I want to go back to
it. I'm going to have to do it before you.
Yeah,
then you're going to think.
If you're excited about carbon fiber, do you need some time alone?
No, that's actually good, Frank.
I know, see?
It's actually good.
Sounds good.
Once it gets cold, it'll stay.
And then, like I said, if it's too much of a bend, you just apply a little bit of heat and it'll just by itself come on. Then. It's still moving, so I just got to hold it. Keep like that a little longer.
Oh, look at that. It's springing back a little bit.
Yeah, but not much, look at that.
No, it's good.
Now I have to pull it back. That's good. Perfect. Now to fix that up, you know, if you want to bring it back, just a little bit of heat out there, it just goes on its own. Uh-oh. Somebody's coming.
Okay,
inside. Right, so this plastic will sit over. Yeah. So we have the lip catches inside there and it holds it into place. Then we put the other one over top. So trim there. 90's here.
Wow.
Actually, this is right on.
That looks good.
Yeah. Yeah, trim up the corners, I think, just so that.
Yeah. And then, like I said, We'll just make some random holes so
let water out.
Water and stuff, comes out, dust. Dust. Water and mud and leaves.
Oh, the leaves never come out. Leaves you gotta pick out.
Yeah. Well, that's what I say, if you make it easy enough, you can take it off.
Yeah.
You know, on and off. And do it in a way where it's easy.
Looks good.
Okay. Take the cover off on the CVT cover. There's that one bolt that's right about here somewhere.
Okay.
It's just a pain. You can't get it out from the top. So we might have to make like a notch like this.
Okay.
So you have to, on the trails, you can get a wrench in there to loosen up that bottom one.
Okay.
Is that the drain one too?
No, that's the CVT cover.
But don't you guys have, this is different. You have a drain. I don't.
Drain you can get out from back there. There's just that hole, you can't get out from the top.
Looks good. So what are we doing here, Frank?
Tapping. You're making a thread in the frame here.
So we're not using the old. Obviously we can't use the old one because there is no side ones before. The molding and the cutting and the shaping is nothing. It's all the rest of this shit that takes time.
But now it should just slide over stuff as opposed to getting hung up on the frame.
It should.
In theory.
Yeah, if you go fast enough, it will glide over. Don't worry.
So now we made a thread.
How many you plan on putting? One in each corner?
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Maybe 10, I guess.
Hmm? How many did you buy?
8.
Well, you can still, what you can do is you can still drill them and tap them. Just you can't put when you back to Home Depot. They're a little long though. Wouldn't you want to get them shorter?
I think you can buy. I was thinking at first it would just go through, drill completely through the frame.
Nah, you wouldn't want that.
Oh, there.
Yeah, that's strong. Are you kidding? That's strong enough. Actually, those are nice.
I'll tighten it up. You
should change yours over too, eh?
Yeah, these are nice. I like these things. That gives you a nice flat edge.
I can actually, the part, or the bag.
Yeah, you got the number? Yeah, perfect. That up,
bend it and burn. That's it.
Take the form, and then the other one it covers over top.